Hey guys, Joe Kistel here. Wanted to make this quick video because doing this was a lifesaver for me. I recently got a new laptop with a high definition 4K resolution screen. So I was real excited about it. This laptop was primarily to use Adobe Production Premium CS6. Computer's an awesome computer, thought it'd work well. It's a Toshiba W50 Tecra model. Fantastic machine, awesome display. And so I went ahead and installed my Adobe Suite and went ahead to play around in Photoshop and open it up, and this is what I got. And as you can see, it is super duper tiny, and I can't work with this. And so I was like, okay, what's the big deal? What's going on here? Did I install something wrong? Blah, blah, blah. So of course I went to the internets and found out that for whatever reason, Adobe with high definition laptop displays seems to be somewhat problematic. Fortunately, I came across a website by Dan Antonielli, and he went through step by step on a way to fix it. And I'm just going to show you that process, how I did it. And again, a big thanks to Dan. I'm going to leave a link to his webpage that shows a step by step in text form. We have to do two things here. We have to go down and make a Windows registry file, I guess is what you'd call it. And then we have to go ahead and make a manifest file and stick it in the folder where our application is. Now I'm going to show this demonstration for Photoshop, but this actually works for all the applications you see here, or all the Adobe applications. So here we go. So first step, we want to go Windows button in R, and that's going to bring up our run. And you want to type in regedit, hit OK, and you're gonna say yes, and click machine. We're gonna go to software, and then we are going to go to Microsoft, and then once we're in Microsoft, we want to go to Windows. I'm looking for Windows, that is a W, Windows, and then we want to go to current version right here. And then we want to go to SideBySide, which is right here. Now we want to right click, okay? And we want to go new, and we want to go to DWORD 32-bit. And okay, now here we have to type in prefer external manifest, okay? Then we want to hit enter. That's there. Okay, now we gotta go ahead and right click on that. Click modify. We wanna change this value from 0 to 1. Click on decimal. So now we wanna close this out. Okay, so now what we need to do is make a manifest file and place it in the program folder where our application is. So basically how this works is this. Here is some text that you want to make a manifest file out of. So you go to File, Save As. Okay, and here's the trick. We want to name this the same exact thing as the executable file for our Adobe application. So we're working with Photoshop. So we're gonna go Photoshop, you can see I have it in there already, .exe .manifest, okay? And then we're going to go save. Okay, then we can close this out. Now we've made our manifest file, okay? And here it is right here. So now what we need to do, we need to go into basically our program files and click on Adobe to find the application. So we want to find out where that executable file is. So we're going to click on here and then scroll down to see if that executable file is in there. And sure enough, there it is. Okay, so you can see we have our Photoshop file here. We want to go ahead and copy our manifest file into here. So I'm going to right click, paste it, and then hit continue. Okay, so now you can see our manifest file is right underneath the Photoshop file. And if we did everything right, if we now open up Photoshop, Look at that. It is normal people, human being size. And so I'm pretty stoked about it. And a big thanks to Dan again for this. Now that's just, I just showed you how to do Photoshop. Now what you do with the other programs as well, you need to do this for all of these. So for example, Premiere Pro, you want to go into here. And as you can see down here, I have got a copy of a manifest file there as well. So it works for those. So you need to do that for every Adobe application. And again, all you got to do to make that file is just go to the text file and then rename it to the exact same name as the executable Adobe program, and then copy and paste that file into the same folder that the executable program file is in. Thanks for watching, guys. If you thought this was helpful, please consider subscribing. I'm Joe Kistel.